All right, so what's going on? So what I have here is an old Siemens X-ray tube unit from a dental unit. It's from a Panorex machine, and I'm gonna go ahead and just take off like the external stuff here first and just kind of show you that. And then once I get everything off, I'll go ahead and set the camera up and take the plate off here so we can go ahead and take out the X-ray tube and check out the transformer inside. All right, so I went ahead and got a couple panels off, and I also got off the collimator assembly here. You can see the small metal strips for the X-ray beam. And here's the actual like collimation tube that's like built in. So all lead lined here inside. There was a giant capacitor here on top. It was right here between here. I did make sure it was safely discharged before, handling it. It is, 400 some volts, and it could give you quite a shock. And then I took off the metal plate that was right here in front of the circuit board. Pretty neat thing. I'm gonna go ahead and take it apart a little bit more before I get to the main housing. All right, so I got the control panel off here. So basically all that's left now is the tube housing. I'm gonna go ahead and, drain the oil and get the X-ray tube out of it. There is a pretty small bellows tube here to allow for expansion. It's like a rubber material and it moves around. That's just because when the oil gets hot, it's gonna expand and you don't wanna overpressurize the case. But yeah, that should be pretty simple to take apart and get the oil out. And here, just a control panel. You can see it has a lot of parts in it, some fuses, resistors, whatnot. Yeah, pretty interesting. I'm just gonna go ahead and throw all of this away, keep some of this copper wiring here and whatnot for other projects I do. All right, next up is taking this apart, getting the oil out, and getting the tube out of it. Okay, I'm gonna start taking apart the X-ray tube here. I'm gonna start by taking out the oil first. It's probably gonna be a lot. And then we'll take off all the other screws here. Hopefully this won't make a big mess. We'll see. On the prior X-ray tubes, the oil is always the messiest part of it. So I could go a few ways. I could take this off and get the oil out, or I'm just gonna take out the bellows tube here. All right, so that's not gonna work. There's something stopping the ring from going down, so I'm gonna have to figure something else out. All right, because this oil is so messy, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut a hole into the rubber and drain it out through here. It's just kind of draining really slowly. Maybe I can make a bigger hole. So that's not working too well. I'm gonna go ahead and take these screws out now and take off that cover. Right, so I got this little piece off. It's like the collimator. Basically, it's just there to narrow down the beam, make sure it's lead lined in here and no X-rays escape. It also has this little channel you can see right here for to make like a thin slice of X-rays. Right, here's some aluminum filtration, it looks like. And yeah, the tube's right underneath this plastic cover, which I'm gonna go ahead and take off now. All right, so let's go ahead and remove the cover here. There you have it. A little plastic cover. You have the O-ring here, which makes the seal so the oil doesn't come out. And the tube is in here. You can see it in some kind of plastic sheet. So it's actually underneath. It's kind of hard to see here. Oh shit. Underneath that plastic. But now I should be able to get my oil out a lot better since it has an air vent. So let's go ahead and get the rest of the oil out. And I'm gonna bring this oil in somewhere for recycling. It's like a special kind of oil that needs to be disposed of properly. So we have the plate loose. Let's go ahead and see if we can. I see the inside here is free. It's moving around. Got to figure out this outer part now. I'm sure it'll pry right off. Let me go get a little flat tip screwdriver. These little holding bars slide out the side, I just found out. There's a little slot right here that it can go through. And it looks like that holds this top piece in place. Alright, that should be it. Yep. Alright, moment of truth. Let's see what's inside here. We have the outer covering plate, a big old O-ring, and the main plate here. Looks like this tube here again, 90 kV, 12 milliamps. Alright, so here we have it, the guts of the system. I just gotta figure out how to take this whole thing apart. Looks like we have a few screws inside holding on this giant plastic cover. So we're gonna go ahead and take off this plastic cover next. I see the tube already. I just gotta cut those wires. So the housing is free. Here's the little expansion tube that I poked the holes in. And all the cable connections to the tube right here. I'm just gonna put this aside. It's gonna go in the trash. Now let's take a look here at the actual assembly. So it looks like it's covered in this plastic. I don't know why. I think it's like Bakelite, some kind of durable plastic. Pretty sure that's what it is. All right, let's go ahead and find a way to get the tube out of here now. It's definitely a small one. It looks nice. Just remember, this was from a Panorex unit. It's a little dental tube. just keep in mind everything is extremely oily, so it's really slippery. Here we go. I got the sleeve separated. Here's that outer sleeve it was sitting in. So let's just set that aside. All right. What we have here is the X-ray inner assembly. Looks like we have a bunch of resistors in series. It's pretty neat. I wonder what that's for, maybe to lower the current a little bit, who knows. Alright, but yeah, my X-ray tube is almost free. It's just right here in this housing. There's a few screws that look to be holding it in, and then we'll be done getting the tube out of it. Not sure what this is. Some kind of coil. There's cables inside of here I can see. Some kind of cables, but I'm not worried about that. I don't really care about anything else. I just want to get the tube out for my collection. But yeah. All right, here's that board in closer detail. Pretty neat. Just a bunch of resistors in series. Alright, here's the tube. There's three screws holding it in and we'll be home free. I just gotta be careful that when I take out the screws it doesn't go flying down, so I'll go ahead and loosen them up a little bit. How's it gonna come out? I guess we need to rotate it. Oh, that little metal bracket in here is actually holding it from coming out. Let's go ahead and see what we can do. There's a little lead sleeve inside of here around the tube. Maybe that needs can slide out. I'm not sure. Also a little cool board here. Let's take a look at that real quick. I have no idea what this board is. I've never seen anything like these. Well, keep in mind, this is from like the early 90s, so technology now is a little bit different. Makes sense. I believe this is a heater. It actually warms up the oil to temperature. It looks like a bunch of resistive elements. Yeah, that's what it is, most likely. Some kind of heating unit. Keep the oil warm. All right, in order to not break the tube trying to get it out, there's a little metal slot in here that's in the way. So I'm gonna have to just remove a couple nubs so I can slide it out. Okay. moment of truth. Let's see if that made enough room to where I can twist it out. Making some progress. There we go. You ready to see the tube for the first time? Here it is. There's the small Panorex unit, little dental tube. I'm gonna cut those cables a little shorter. Yeah, pretty neat. I'll probably just take the cables off, to be honest. Even though I can make it glow with the cables. I'll check that out real quick. But yeah, there's the tube. I'll get it cleaned up a little bit and we'll take a closer look at it. Alright, so here I have the tube all cleaned up. Again, this is an old Siemens Panorex tube. It's very small, doesn't use a lot of KV or MA. Looking closer at it in here. That's where your filament is, right inside here. Let's see if we can get a shot. There you can kind of see it right there. The tiny little filament. And then this is the cathode side and the anode side. You have a little focusing window here in the anode. These are just the two cables that went to the cathode side. That's a pretty cool little tube. I'm going to leave the base on it so I can make a stand for it and go ahead and stand it up. And you can actually go ahead and hook it up to a 12 volt battery. And you can make the filament light up. And it does not make any X-rays this way, just so you know. Let's go ahead and show it a little closer. Yeah, that's it, all lit up. It's pretty cool. Let's get a close up here. All right, hope you enjoyed the video.